You're too far on the edge.
Damn, we need more ice. I'm too far on the edge. Hey, what's up?
Woo! I forgot to put my mic on.
It's a hot day in Cali. We're out here drinking. Happy Still Sunday to everybody.
Trying to stay hydrated?
I think alcohol dehydrates people. I don't know. Trying to stay dehydrated. We're trying to stay dry.
Yeah, with some good stuff. That
We got that Speedway Stout. It's probably backwards for them. You can't.
Well, we need like a mirror or something. But yeah,
some music.
Earlier we tried this one, so
I think they're everybody left.
Yep.
Play some music. Here, I'm gonna get more ice. I'll be back. Sure, you just chill. Fuck it. Whoever says something.
Waiting for Juan to come back with some ice. What's up, homie? Man Cave Musings. Mm-hmm. The homie Man Cave Musings, he said. Whoa. He said, "What's up, homie?"
What's up? What's up? We're gonna get drunk.
Oh.
A little buzz already.
Already? I ate before I came. I ate a.
How you guys doing?
Pizza.
Pop this, we got this Rasputin.
Oh. He's got his weapon right there.
Beer gun.
The camera's on that side.
Oh shit. Well, the bottle's over there. So So how was the Speedway Stout?
It was surprisingly good. I thought it was gonna be more like
burden-wise right now. Too hot in Texas. Wow, I can't even imagine. Hey, what's up, Bato?
It's over here, what, 95 over here.
Is it?
I think so, yeah.
It's getting cooler. Yesterday it was 100, right? 100 or something.
Yeah.
And where I work, actually, I work next to like a fire. Like there's a fire going on in the
Oh, man. Yeah, you're by the hills, yeah.
I'm like miles away from this fire. So it felt like the whole city was barbecuing, basically.
102 degrees over there.
102? Fuck that. you better move out of there. I don't know. Well, we got beer to cool us down, right? Fuck it.
Yeah.
So how was the Speedway Stout?
I liked it. I don't remember the last time I had it, but it is pretty smooth. Like, yeah.
Well, we had this
Angel City.
Angel City Crawler. It was a Belgian ale, and it was pretty good. So that
pernicious advice.
Pernicious advice. Whatever the fuck that means. But it tasted good. What does that say? Cheers! Cheers!
Cheers! What? Carnales.
Carnales. Well, I just popped this. North Coast Rasputin, and we're about to dig into that shit.
We started with a Belgian ale, then a
Speedway Stout.
This is Imperial Stout with coffee.
I made a cool picture with that. Well, he helped me out. It's gonna be dropping like maybe tomorrow.
Whenever he feels like it.
Whenever we sober up. Woo! What's up? So yeah, look out for that next picture. It's gonna be a pretty cool picture. Dropping whenever. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Am I pouring it right? He's a pour.
You're no, pouring. Look at it. Look
I'm
at all that foam.
At, oh, show me how to pour. Show me
all,
how to pour.
Look at all that foam right there.
Usually, I don't like to drink with ice because, you know, it's not as fancy, right? You're not supposed to drink. But, oh, my God.
The
you
beer,
know what?
The beer snobs say you don't put ice in it.
You know what I just remembered? I bought these fucking things called, they're called whiskey stones.
Oh, yeah.
If anybody's heard of it right there. What's that thing? Rim pour. Rim pour? Rim pour.
I don't know.
Oh, I don't know. I guess my pour sucks. Look at this.
A little bit better.
Well, anyways, these doesn't help that the beer's warm. Like keep your beer warm or your alcohol warm. Or, I mean, cold. I'm buzzed. I'm going to bring it.
Bring it.
I forgot I had
Are
I
they
even,
cold, though?
I forgot I... Yeah. Oh, okay. I forgot I even bought those.
He's mainly a beer drinker, so he's never heard of whiskey stones. Normally, he puts ice in it. Not bad. Here's the one. North Coast Rasputin. It's a good, some good stuff. I remember it being like more rough. I think it was maybe my first time.
Rough?
my first time trying an Imperial Stout. Like,
no,
oh man.
Ice? No ice, vato.
See, told you. No, not ice.
Look, I have these things called soapstones, whiskey stones. And they're...
Oh, they are cold.
They're supposed to make your
yeah, without diluting it.
Cold.
Yeah, without diluting it.
Here, get a couple. Never had these before.
Fancy, look at... Happy now? No ice.
It's cold. It's hot as shit out here. You don't know about...
Oh, no.
Drink it. It's hot as fuck out here in Cali. There's fires everywhere. We're in the hell. We're in Mordor. We're in fucking Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, it's burning. Yeah,
volcano.
It's burning all around us.
All the ice we can get.
Where'd you get these at? These are cool.
I got those at Marshalls. I completely forgot about them.
Have you seen the big glass that they do, like the ice orb? What they do in whiskey? Those are cool.
Ice orbs?
Yeah, it's like a big ice, but it's like that big, like big round. And it fits inside the little whiskey, like cups or whatever.
I haven't seen it.
And it's made to like slowly go down, so it doesn't dilute it.
Bones are pearls, so more bubbles. Stones are okay, but no ice. Well, I forgot I had the stones. I didn't even fucking remember.
These ones are stuck together.
This is just the pregame. We're gonna go somewhere, right? And
yeah, we're still trying to figure out where.
A dine-in, and we're gonna do a review from there. We're gonna do a video from wherever it is and review some beers. There's a lot of restaurants and stuff. There's a lot of bars that still let you dine in. So we're gonna see which one we can.
Maybe we should find like a small place, support them, small business.
Yeah, I mean, places are falling down like flies out here. It's just like these little businesses like everywhere. Just here one day, gone the next, and. Some of our favorite businesses, some of our favorite places to get. Oh, you know what? Stuffed sandwiches. I always tell you
they
about
that. They have beer there?
Oh my God, they have over 700 types of beer.
Wow. This oh, that place. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
The German
in Cali,
place?
In San Gabriel. It's not German. It's this place where they call the owner the beer Nazi.
That's what I was about to say. Wasn't it like a Nazi guy?
Modern Times finally hit Texas. Oh, congratulations. You get some good shit.
Modern Times is some good stuff.
Austin, Texas, to be exact.
I didn't try that beer yet, that the one that you posted, but the liquor store by me.
That reminds me. I was going to tell you, like, I looked up what are the strongest beers in California, and Modern Times has the strongest beer in California right
now. I think
now.
They do, like big bottles, though. Like, they do, like, barrel-aged, double barrel-aged stuff.
Well, I was looking for my phone. My phone's up there recording this. But Modern Times has like the strongest beer allowed in California or something.
Wow. So what is it?
I don't know. My phone's over there. You look it up.
It's like 20% or something.
So somebody tell me. Anyways, what was I saying?
This one's not bad. You're just telling about the Nazi sandwich guy.
Oh yeah, there's this place right here in San Gabriel, California, called Stuffed Sandwiches, and the people who run it, they have like decades of being in the brewing and beer industry.
I've never been there, but I passed by it a bunch of times.
I've been there, and they decided to start their own restaurant, and the guy, he passed away like a few years back, but they called him the beer Nazi. Because if you would go in there, he'd ask you, what do you know about this beer? What does this beer have? And if you didn't,
you have to appreciate anything, it. You have to have the knowledge. Exactly. He's not just going to give you some good beer to some person that's never tried like an Imperial Stout. And exactly. They're going to be like, if you know what, this is nasty.
Appreciate the beer, he would not give it to you.
Yeah.
And they call them the beer Nazi, like like in Seinfeld, the soup Nazi. There's still fireworks going on here. My neighbors have fucking fireworks.
And they're wondering why there's fires all over.
But yeah, and I went there once, and they have all kinds of beer, over 700 types of beer.
Wow.
And big-ass bottles of beer, little bottles of beer, all kinds of beer on the wall, and it's great.
Man.
Hopefully, they're still open, and we can support them.
Yeah.
Like, I'd be down to go there. And
that would be neat, yeah, because I've never been there.
Do a video.
I think, remember, like, the last few times we tried to go there, it was always closed. I think they have, like, special, like, secret hours or something,
because... I think because, like I said, the guy passed away.
That was before the COVID stuff, and it was still...
Well, the guy passed away, and just his wife is the main owner, I guess. And, you know, I guess they have limited hours now, but hopefully they're still there, because that was a great place to go and have a drink, and... Honestly, I never even had their sandwiches. I just had the beers.
Wow.
Because the beers are amazing. They had a flight right there too, like a 10,
oh, okay.
10 little cup flight I had.
That's cool.
Just with 10 little cups, it messed me up. And it was like 20.
Well, knowing you, you probably got all Imperial Stouts.
Yeah, like 10%, 9%. Great time.
Yeah.
Does the Stones give you a little hint of different flavor?
Like, no.
I don't know. I'm tasting something different. Maybe it's... I don't know. Maybe.
Oh, yeah. Like a plasticky taste.
It is. Something.
Did you wash them? You're supposed to wash them.
I rinsed them. I don't know if I washed them.
Yeah, it's that same smell.
The stone. What the fuck? They're poisoning us. I don't know, but yeah, it does give it a weird taste.
That's alright. It's not. It doesn't make you say, like, hey, I can't drink this beer no more.
I know, it doesn't make it undrinkable, but it's still a weird taste. A hint of a weirdness. Oh, have you had that one I had last night?
No, I was actually debating on going and getting it.
Anna and Hammer in the freezer, carnal.
Arm and Hammer.
Arm and Hammer. Yeah, probably my freezer's fucking dirty. It probably is. I'm not very up with
I actually have that stuff in my beer fridge at home. I have two of those things.
Yeah, hey, I'll give
Arm & Hammer
some of these Stones. Take some.
That'd be cool.
It's only like $5.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, I'll just buy myself then.
Other than that, though, it's pretty good.
Yeah, I like it.
I ran
That's why I said... before, when I first tried it, I remember it being like so nasty, so bitter. It's because I wasn't used to the Imperial Stouts back then.
Oh, way back in the day.
And now that I try it now, it's like,
is this the ghetto bird?
No, it's like an Apache.
It's a Black Hawk.
Yeah.
Holy shit, there's a military Black Hawk flying right above us right now.
Where I live, they do it constantly, like the big Osprey, like the Osprey ones, ones with their...
Oh, I've never seen the Osprey.
They come like three in a pair, they're flying through.
I remember when the Iraq War was happening, I saw a fucking line of those big-ass helicopters that take the tanks, that you could put a tank
in. Oh, okay, yeah, the aircraft carrier thing.
That shit woke me up in the middle of the
night. Oh, yeah.
I was like, what the fuck? And there was a huge line of them, a bunch of them.
The scary thing is that you don't hear them until they're like already leaving. Okay, like, can you imagine, like, in the war, like, in the actual war?
Oh, yeah.
Like, they're, like, right above your house, and you don't even hear them until they're already gone.
It's like Modern Warfare, that level.
Oh, yeah.
Have you played the level where they're shooting from the sky?
Yeah, yeah.
That big-ass airplane? Yeah.
The AC-130.
Oh, Osprey equals Widowmaker.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That thing is crazy.
I was seeing Osprey when I went to San Diego.
Yeah, we went to that air show.
Oh, well, I went before you another time, because we did go to an air show in San Diego together, and that was pretty badass. We
yeah, saw, they showed like, all the
fighter planes.
Like the Harrier and stuff, the one that it just hovers, like an airplane that actually hovers straight up, and then the Harrier just takes off like nothing.
But I went before, and we were driving on the freeway, me and my friend, and... Yeah. Like, oh shit, what the fuck is
I know,
that?
I thought my windows were gonna break,
like,
or something.
Oh my god, it's a fucking Osprey. What are you saying? Hey, what's up? What are you guys drinking? You drinking anything?
Yeah, we're
right
just
now?
Chilling here drinking beers. What are you guys drinking? Man Cave Musings. Are you drinking anything?
We're almost done with the Rasputin.
It says never say die.
Man, I wish we could go back to the bars and drink that shit on draft.
Yeah, that, you know, the good old days.
I don't know why they're hating on the bars right now. Like, every news thing I see is they always blame the bars, number one. And restaurants, number two. They're like, we need to shut down the bars and we need to shut down restaurants because of the COVID shit.
I think they're thinking of like the super packed bars. Like, have you ever been to a bar where like you can barely walk up to the bar? It's like a super packed. People are like that jam packed.
Yeah, all of them get to that point at some time. I mean, I get it.
Especially
yeah.
if like the NFL game's on or something.
But the thing that sucks is.
What did he say? He's drinking something.
Independence Brewing Cucumber Berliner Weiss. Wow.
Oh, wow. That sounds interesting.
Interesting. I'm a little fancy.
Fancy.
Cucumber? How's that?
I like the cucumber.
But anyways, I was saying, because like they're letting restaurants do dine in, but they don't let bars do that. I guess unless they serve food, but even then, they don't. Some of them are not letting them.
I think, well, no, now the bars, like, there's some, like, small breweries that don't even serve food at all. And they're actually, like, bringing food trucks to the actual brewery. Because they don't normally serve food, but the only way they can stay open is if they're selling food with it right now. So, well, remember last week I went to Angel City?
If establishment has more than 50% from alcohol, Texas, shut them down. What does that mean?
Wow. Saying if the place has more than 50% alcohol. Oh, that's weird. I guess for us it's different. As long as they serve food, then it doesn't matter. They can still...
In California, I think they have to serve food. If they serve food, they're still available to do dine-in.
Yeah.
But some people are getting mad. Like, I work at a newspaper, so I know the reporter did an article on this one guy who refused to shut down, and the government came and shut him down.
Oh,
and
man.
He was, like, all fucking fighting them. More than 50% from alcohol sales, you get shut down.
Wow.
So if you have more than 50% sales from alcohol in Texas, you get shut down.
Wow, that's crazy. If anything, that just makes people go to the liquor stores instead of the breweries then. Like, you just go to a liquor store and then just... That kind of hurts the business, I think.
Yeah, but I guess I just miss going out to the bars and hanging out and, you know, all the good times and all of it. It sucks.
Well, remember last week I went to Angel City and with my dad. I took my dad down to downtown, and we made a pit stop to Art District Brewery.
Oh, really? You got anything there?
Yeah, we got some beers there, and then we had to order like an appetizer or something. Well, you had to order some kind of food, and we just got like the smallest little thing.
You had to order food.
Yeah,
beer?
You can't beer. You can't get like beer without without food.
Even online, like
no, we dined in. We dined in on the well, they had a little outdoor patio thing.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So hey, I got my dad. I got my dad like the lightest beer, and I was actually surprised he liked it.
Breweries are only beer to go.
Wow.
They're in Texas, I guess.
Over here,
what the fuck? There's ice cream man. There's still ice cream out here.
We have an ice cream man that comes by every day at my house.
Wow, I didn't know the ice cream man still.
We have a elote man too.
Ice cream! Ice cream! You have a beer. We have a beer.
The ice cream man on my house, he sells nachos, he sells monsters, he sells some good stuff.
Hey bro, you have any beer?
Well, I remember you read that article about the guy that was selling beer, remember?
Oh, and Ali Taco. Yeah, there's
a Ali Taco. It's gonna be like an ice cream man going through the neighborhood, but it sells beer.
Yeah, over here in LA, we got a drive-up beer place, liquor store.
Craft beer.
These guys just rolling up on the liquor. Paletes forever.
Yeah.
I want a choco taco. So, you want to still go to a place or what?
We can, I guess, just... I don't know if Grilla Mall's open, because I looked it up, they said that they were closed. But they posted that thing like a few days ago.
Look up on...
We could try that stuff sandwich place. If it's open. Yeah. So if anything, we might do a second live, if we can.
Either live or we're just going to do a segment. We're going to record and, you know, release it. I am hungry. And we're out of beer.
Are you about to get that ice cream?
Nah, I'll save it for wherever.
I don't know if you can hear the ice cream man. You should be able to hear him.
Hey, you want to be on my podcast?
Hey, it's a young guy too. I thought it was gonna be some old guy.
He's chilling right there.
Now that I'm getting to the bottom, I can taste those whiskey stones.
No, I think I need to clean those whiskey stones. It tastes like stones.
Yeah, it does. Yeah. Good job, Juan.
Well, I forgot I fucking had it anyways, so. I thought I had more beers. Oh, yeah, I would drink it. The Wizards and Gargoyles.
Did they only come in 4-packs?
Yeah, it was pretty pricey, too. It was like... $14.
See, now that you have Modern Times, maybe they'll have it over there. Man Cave Musings. It's a collaboration.
Collab for Modern Times and Stone.
Yeah.
My dogs are barking from the audio of the ice cream truck.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Sorry. You know what? My dad actually buys an ice cream cone for my dog. I have a German Shepherd.
Oh, yeah. I saw that last time. He
went and chased the ice cream man down just to get an ice cream for my dog. He loves it.
Oh, he bought me one, too. One.
Yeah. And the dog just licks it. He doesn't, like, chomp it. So he already knows how to eat it.
German Shepherd.
Yeah. He's big. He's, like, that big.
He's getting old now, right?
Yeah. He's, like, 8 years old. So he's kind of... He's a little slower now, but...
Oh, yeah. Time goes by.
Yeah. But he still likes to hang around. I don't know if you ever hear him in the podcast. You might hear him whining and crying and stuff.
Yeah, if you listen to our podcast, you might hear the dog whining or something. The earlier ones might have been Oscar. He might have been
Oscar.
I don't know. But yeah. And I thought I had more beer than that.
I actually bought another one from Angel City, a big bottle, like that, like a 22 ounce bottle or something, called Funky Wit.
Funky Wit, I think I heard of that.
I don't think I've tried that one either, so I just have it in my fridge for now. I didn't want to bring it.
I have a $30 watch. That's much.
What?
I have $30. Want ads much.
What does that mean?
What? I don't know what that means. Wait. My dog. Ew, there's fucking flies on me. So where do you want to go eat?
I say we try the stuff place first and see if that place is even open.
Is it even open? Like, look it up.
Well, that place seems like they don't have a social media. It doesn't look. Maybe, I don't know.
No, but you can look it up on Google Maps. That's where.
But they haven't updated them. Sometimes, like, I'll go to...
Google Maps says it's closer or it's open.
Because I'll go to places and they'll ask me questions. They'll be like, oh, is this place open during COVID stuff?
On Google Maps?
Yeah, they'll ask me questions like that. Because they want to better their...
Hello, Flip FL. Is it hot where you're at? Where it's hot as fuck over here at Cali, California, Los Angeles, yeah. California.
Yeah, we're dying out here.
It's hot as hell.
And then drinking dark beer doesn't really help either. I think we need like some IPAs, refreshing stuff.
Some white ale. White ale. I remember you bought a white ale.
You know what? Yeah, uh-huh. That,
very fucking good.
Dragon's white. Milk.
No.
Not Dragon's white, Milk, white stout.
Not white stout.
Oh, white ale?
I think it was somebody else then.
I remember the white ale too.
Maybe it was you then.
It was,
some white ale.
It was like a something devil, like a rascal devil or something like that.
I don't know, but I remember, like, ever since I wanted it and I can't remember.
I said it's only open for takeout.
Oh.
I guess we'll go to, our place by my house is open, Downey Brewery.
All the way to your house? Fuck.
Take your scooter. You can scooter back.
You want to get a DUI? I got this new scooter. Yeah. Paid a pretty penny for this fucking scooter.
Goes scoot,
pretty
scoot.
Fast, but scoot, you scoot. Still get a DUI on a scooter. You gotta be fucking scooting drunk. All willy-nilly.
But no, the bus will take you right here, and you're just scooting right here.
Let's end this shit with showing me on the scooter.
Yeah.
You want
to
do it?
Oh, you want to do that?
All right, I'll take.
Are you already drunk?
Just take it off of this.
Look at Juan on the scooter right there.
Just got this sucker today. Pretty buzz. Probably not gonna die. Hopefully not. It's a dead end. I live in a dead end street.
If he can survive this street, then he can survive
I'll
home.
I'll be alright. It's the top of the line scooter. I'll see you guys when I see ya. Bye.
Here he comes.
Talk on top. Goodbye, everybody.